With Corticon.js Studio, rule modelers can develop, test, and package a single set of business rules as decision services and share those decision services with JavaScript developers who can then run those rules anywhere that JavaScript runs. Let's use a car rental application with a mobile front end to demonstrate how to decide the insurance fees to add to an applicant's rental agreement. The car rental agency has a standard set of insurance premium rates based on the applicant's age, gender, and the level of coverage for damages to the car. We capture these policies as rules and apply those rules automatically to every applicant. This decision service needs the flexibility to run offline embedded on the client or remotely on a server. Here's one of the many rules used to decide an additional fee for insurance. Data is required to make a decision, and data is also required to act on that decision. The vocabulary defines the data as entities and attributes. Entities tend to be nouns, in this case, applicant, and attributes provide descriptive information about the entities, in this case, age, gender, damage waiver, and premium. We use a Corticon project to organize our files. The vocabulary is stored in an ECORE file. A vocabulary defines the data for making decisions and assigning values based on those decisions. Here, the applicant is the entity with attributes like age, gender, and damage waiver used to decide the premium to charge. Rules are captured within a rule sheet. The rule sheet is similar to a spreadsheet. A rule is a column that represents an if-then statement with conditions and actions. If all the conditions are satisfied, then the actions are performed. In this case, premium value is set. This rule is one of 10 rules defined by the business rule modeler. There are analytical tools that are available for you to check rules during development for things like logical conflicts, completeness, unintended loops, and hidden dependencies. Let's check for conflicts. We have none. To test rules, you must create a test sheet. You must supply input values and optionally supply expected values. Then you run the rules and compare the output to the expected values. Our values match, so the tests look good. Rule modelers will want to export the input and expected values for JavaScript developers to use as a guide for input and expected values. Here we show how to generate input values and expected values. When testing is complete, we add rule sheets to a rule flow by dragging and dropping onto the rule flow. Rules have one or more rule sheets that are packaged as a decision service. In this example, there is one rule sheet in our rule flow. We save before packaging the rule flow. If you add multiple rule sheets to a rule flow, then you will want to create a test sheet to test how the rule sheets interact within the rule flow. You have the choice of how you package your backend decision service. Corticon.js is cloud agnostic, and the decision service can be packaged for serverless deployment as an Azure function, AWS Lambda function, or on any cloud platform that supports JavaScript. For this demonstration, we'll package as an Azure function. Select Project, Package Rules for Deployment. Select Azure Functions as the target platform. Select the rule flows for deployment. Select an output directory, and click Finish. At this point, the rule modeler is ready to hand off the files to the JavaScript developer. The decision service bundle.js contains the decision service details and is placed on the client or deployed on Azure. The azure.sample.js provides an example of how to call the decision service. And optionally, to help with testing, we will add the sample JSON values we exported earlier. The JavaScript developer or integrator can use the azure.js.file as a model for their code. You will need to include the bundle, store the payload, and execute the decision service. Based on that sample, let's take a look at how the application calls the embedded decision service. The file imports the bundle The UI collects and stores the details in the Corticon payload, and the execute statement calls the decision service and assigns the premium value to the Corticon payload. For the remote call, the decision service bundle is deployed on a server. Once on the server, there are many ways to use it. In this example, it is exposed as a REST endpoint, and the code is an HTTP POST request. If you want to explore this sample further, you can download it from GitHub. The instructions include setting up the sample application and additional code for testing and error handling in the native script mobile car rental application. This concludes our look at how rule modelers develop, test, and package business rules with Corticon.js, and those rules are shared with JavaScript developers who can then call those rules from anywhere JavaScript runs. To learn more about Corticon.js, visit the Corticon Information Hub.